lots and lots of energy. This is where we're going to form an electrochemical gradient using all of these electrons in order to pump hydrogen ions and make the maximum amount of ATP. So the majority of ATP is made in the electron transport chain. I can't emphasize that enough. It'll come up on test questions over and over. ATP is made in the electron transport chain and chemiosmosis. People often think that it comes from the Krebs cycle. Not lots of the energy comes from the Krebs cycle, but it's on electron transporters getting ready to go to the main event. So ATP synthase is the enzyme that I've introduced before that is involved in this oxidative phosphorylation, right? We had substrate level, and now we have oxidative phosphorylation is going to happen in the process of chemiosmosis and the electron transport chain. So now we move into looking at what has happened so far and where we're going. So we have NADH and FADH electron carriers. We've got some of them. NADH is from glycolysis. We got some of them from pyruvate oxidation. Just two from each, for each glucose molecule. But now we've had a lot of them coming from the Krebs cycle. It's time to take them to the electron transport chain, where we will create a proton gradient using proton pumps. This is where the hydrogens come into play. They didn't just come along for no reason. We're going to pump hydrogens into the intermembrane space in the mitochondria, and that's going to create an electrochemical gradient that they don't like. And so they are going to whiz through ATP synthase, and the speed of them whizzing through ATP synthase will result in making lots and lots of ATP. So it's the energy of spinning ATP synthase that really does it all.